Hey guys, Jankar here. Welcome to today's realistic review in which we are taking a look at the F2A3 Buffalo sitting at 2.7 beta rating. Time for some shenanigans, let's say. I did fly it out yesterday and I had a lot of fun in this plane. The speed in the plane is decently nice. It is nothing spectacular, but it's okay. This is in indicated airspeed without Mach. 455 kilometers an hour at sea level without whip and 470 with whip. At 4500 meters, 402 without whip and 423 with whip. And finally at 6500 meters, 362 without whip and 380 with whip. Now that's all right, that's quite all right. Plane is best in mid to low altitudes, although it also performs at the higher altitude. It doesn't drop off that much. Now we've got several legs coming in. I had two on my right engaged with several others, and I had this leg coming in straight for me. So I decided to start with this guy, actually rolling over the top, putting flaps up, letting gravity do the work, pull me down, and I get a shot here, but kinda mess up my aim. I was still getting used. This was my second match, and the 50 cals do work quite differently from the planes that I flew before when it comes to aiming. But we get him leg three out of the way. We've got two other guys there. They are fighting against five other guys, so why not help? I always work from high to low, try to do that as much as possible. This guy is actually going stall a few of those guys out, and he seems to be coming for me after that. But top speed in a dive in this Buffalo is 723 before it redlines and 760 before it reached the ground in my test. Twice I dove down from around 7000 meters and I couldn't get it past 760, and I crashed into the ground, unfortunately. So I mean the rip speed must be slightly higher, but not much. But I couldn't reach it in any case. Difficult to rip this plane, that's for sure. The control stiffening in the plane, it starts only at 500 kilometers an hour, and that is not too badly either. And then at 650 it becomes severe, especially in the roll rate. The elevator stays functional even to 700 kilometers an hour, although you don't want to be right on top of the ground when you start to pull out, of course. We've got a cap 2 here, as I decided that that other plane, that Yak, had too much speed and I couldn't get to him anyway. So I decided to help the Spitfire here. I had a bit of trouble. He was already fighting these two guys for a while. So I decided I might be useful here. Well, there were already five planes on higher altitude that were going after these Yaks and that Aero Cobra. So here we go. I helped the guy out, got two kills as well while helping. So that's good. And we are going on to our next target there. Stall speed in this plane is 165, which is average. The firepower in the plane is very good though. You have four 12.7 M2 Browning machine guns, better known as 50 cals. The two of them in the nose have 250 rounds per gun, and the two in the wings have 400 rounds per gun. I used stealth belt in this match and a 600 meter convergence. The plane can also be equipped with two 100 pound bombs, which can be quite nice if you want to do some ground pounding as well. This one is not gonna be killed before I turn around. I get a hit on him and he gets a hit on me, blackening part of my tail, but fortunately not the elevator itself, but the horizontal stabilizers. That is good. Now let's get this Yak 2 out of the ground. Of course, out of the air, he cannot, of course, kill me, outturn me. He can kill me in another situation, but not in a pure turn like this. Sustained turn, he has no chance. Although the Yak 2 cab is actually quite maneuverable for a heavy fighter, let's say. But that was nice. Very good firepower then with 450 cals, and the ammo load is excellent, especially on the two wing-mounted guns. Performance, the acceleration in a straight line is decent, in a dive slightly better, good. And the energy retention is decent to good in the horizontal. In the vertical it's decent. It is not the best performing plane on this earth, especially not in up gears where you face a lot of good planes that can definitely give you a problem. But this plane always has an ace up its sleeve, and that is its turn time, which is good and very good with flaps. The climb rate is average to decent, and with a bit of side climbing you can get some altitude. Many planes though will be capable of outturning you. This is a nemesis, this plane. It is a very good plane, and all these things have much better energy retention, much better acceleration, and very good boom and zoom capabilities, which is difficult to defend against in the Buffalo. But of course it can turn, and it does turn better than the P-39, so you have that. Then you gotta go and let people come in and turn at the right time and let them make the mistake shenanigans which is always nice. But like I said, yeah, the turn time, good to very good with flaps. The flaps only rip off at 470, which means you can only rip them off in a dive, which is always quite comforting. Use them in a turn and you usually will already be out of the turn and have them retracted already before you reach the speed where they rip off. Roll rate is average in the plane. Overall maneuverability is good. There is no overheating in this plane, nothing to speak of. It is really not an issue, and if you ever manage to get it overheated, it's very easy to cool them off. So that's very nice. Durability is also quite good. It's a tough little bugger. It's quite good. Can take a hit or two. Very nice. It's a boom and zoomer that can turn as well. And it is not a dedicated boom and zoomer. It's not, definitely not a good energy fighter, but it can manage in some situations. And the turn fighting in it is really enjoyable. So there is that. I actually did not see that guy come in. I was checking my rear, as you saw. I was doing 360 checks and stuff like that, but maybe he was right above me. I didn't quite check right on top of me, and that's where he must have come from, where he must have been hiding. He did come from the side at a certain point, but you know, sometimes you have that, a situational awareness glitch. Now, we went back to the airfield. We were a little bit damaged. We reloaded, repaired, and here we are. It's a 3-2. And my ally here just said, I don't have enough experience playing RB. When I told him to stick together, and because I knew these guys would be higher, and at least climbing. And the Yak 9 definitely is higher, so he's coming from above. And while he's attacking, the P-39 can also come in at his leisure, let's say. So let's pull this guy in and see if we can make him turn the pool underneath. And here comes the P-39 as well. Now this is where the shenanigans start in this plane. Let's see if we can scare him off from a head-on. Of course he cannot see that I'm shooting, but he may hear the bullets fly by, of course. We get a critical. That fire actually started later. What the heck? Maybe the P-40 hit him, but I got the crit from that. I don't know how that worked. There comes a Yak 7 as well, so we have all three planes in our view. Yak 9 was extending, better energy than me. P-39 is heavily damaged from the fire and is coming underneath here. We do get a very nice shot on his right wing there. Fantastic, shoot him out of the sky, take him out. You know, he could still be dangerous even if he is hurt. Pulling in for the Yak 7 here. And we are pulling right behind him as he is focused completely on the P-14, on my ally. Come on. Come on with your lead, man. Got a lead a little bit. Yes, that's it. A crit, but still no cigar. Come on. The Yak is not coming to help. It's still extending, which is okay by me. Another hit. Come on. Yes. Yes. Okay, there we go. Take off the right wing again. And my sixth kill in this match. Fantastic shenanigans. So the Yak 9 actually extended. P-40 was higher up as well, and he actually got his kill as well. This match. So nicely done, we won. I also got a ground target, of course, somewhere along the way, and a very nice showcase for this plane. Let's see what kind of rewards we got for that performance. We've got Survivor, Terror of the Sky, 32,000 Silver Lions, and 2,000 Research Points. I'll see you in the conclusion. Hey guys, so here we are after the match. Now the Buffalo, it was fun to revisit this one as well. I revisited very recently two Buffaloes, this one and the other one, the A one. And both are fantastic shenanigans. This one is a little bit higher beta rating, with but you have better guns, let's say. We now have 450 cals, which is quite devastating firepower. You do get up tiers to 3.7 though, and that is F4 territory, a difficult plane to fight against, and there is many other very good planes here as well at this beta rating. So up tiers can be quite tough, but it is capable to fly this plane in such a manner that she can compete. And you just need your turn fighting skills and your situational awareness to see them coming, because they will be above you in this plane. That's mostly true. In the down tiers and on its beta rating, it can be equal, or you can even outclimb some people, which is quite nice. But in the up tiers especially, you get a lot of planes that climb better than you, so be aware of that. Then you're in the shenanigans department, where you can turn, you know, pull them in, turn and burn, or let them burn. But a fantastic little plane, and in the down tiers you can absolutely boom and zoom in this plane. It can energy fight just a little bit, but I would use it in those two departments. Boom and zooming when you're down tiered, and when you're up tiered, go for the shenanigans and the turn fighting. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button, become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video, do leave me a comment, and if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.